everybody. Welcome back to Project Happy Home. For those of you who are new here, I'm Tanya, a doctor lawyer turned homeschooling mom of three kids, ages 7, 4, and now newly 3. I'm so excited. I'm really excited about this video. I'm going to be telling you about some of our favorite Usborne books, because I'm going to be hosting a YouTube Usborne book party tomorrow with my friend Claire, who I met on Instagram, a children's book lover. And she is an Usborne consultant, and she will be on site tomorrow, and you'll see her in my video as well. And if you guys have book lists that you'd like her to create or lists that you'd like to buy from Usborne, you can go through her link and check it out. In return for hosting the party, I believe I get some free Usborne materials, and I am looking forward to giving away some of those, hopefully directly from Usborne. So I'd love it if you would help out and watch the video tomorrow and participate in the party. In no particular order, I'm just going to clear these out, and I have more than this actually, and I'll show you some of our favorite resources from Usborne. For any homeschooling family, they are amazing books, and you'll see what I mean in a second. This tiny little book, That's Not My Dinosaur, which is an Usborne touchy Feely book, is one of my favorite books that we have in our library and one of my favorite Usborne book series. And the reason is because it was my very first gift at my baby shower for my eldest. And this is the exact copy, and it has withstood 3 very rambunctious children so far with just a little bit of tape here. The That's Not My Dinosaur and That's Not My series are squishy and touchy-feely. So here the dinosaur is touchy-feely. It has like a fuzzy tail, and every page has like some texture for the babies to feel. My kids always like looking for the mouse as well. And at the end you find the dinosaur, and they love how we read it, and it's just the sturdiest, sweetest little board book for kids. And all 3 of them have very different personalities, and all 3 of them have loved this book. And now it's really sweet because my middle daughter will grab these books to read to her baby dolls, so she approves of them as a mom as well. So Usborne has a range of books, from little kid books all the way to big kid books. They also have activity books like this first number sticker book, and I really like the way they do their sticker books and things like that, because they're often in full color with photographs. Some of them have illustrations as well. They come with stickers like this. This one has number stickers as well as like star stickers and dot stickers, and it'll clearly say what picture they belong in, and they're just really fun interactive books for kids. Another wonderful book we love is this art sticker book, and I think I have 3 different versions of their art sticker books. Let me see if it says on the back. I think I have the Impressionist one as well as 2 others, and I can't recall which ones they are. But if you can see here, it shows the impression of the painting just very faintly, and then as you turn forward, you have the stickers in full color. And the children can find the stickers that are necessary for a page, put them in, and there's also information about each of the stickers and the painters. So this particular book is split up into categories, like these are paintings of towns and cities, these are paintings illustrating color and self-portraits. I don't know about you guys, but when I have a sticker book, my kids are immediately engaged, and we use them in our regular coursework and just inject some variety into the day. This one is a human body sticker book that I actually bought for this year, and we haven't started using it yet. But see, you can see the stickers are in full bleed color, and there's even x-ray stickers there. The quality of Usborne books is just incomparable, really. And as you can see, these aren't throwaway sticker books. Even after you use the stickers, there's really nice information in here. Here's a timeline of the history of medicine, some facts and records. I really like how they show the illustration even before the sticker is there, so kids, as they're reading the description, can get something out of it, and it makes finding the sticker much easier. Speaking of art again, this is one of our favorite resources from Usborne. It's their famous paintings cards, and I believe they have a set for Impressionist paintings as well, which I have been meaning to get. But if you can see, these cards are really nice and sturdy, and we basically, so here's Starry Starry Night, we basically use them just as table talk, and I will leave one up on the board for the entire week. And they are like a small, easily handled size. It's really easy to prop it up on the table when we want to discuss a painting. And we can pass it around and they can hold it, and they're really sturdy. On the back of the painting cards, you can see that there's information about all of them. They also have a cute little feature where they ask you to look for something else. So here they'll highlight little features of the painting and the artist that we might not know from just initial inspection. So they point out that you should look for the reflections of the water lilies and other things about Monet. So Usborne also makes a huge variety of straight up nonfiction books for children. And you'll notice that a lot of them say internet linked at the top. This one I picked up because I'm really interested in comparative religion. And although I'm a secular homeschooler, I like exposing my children to a variety of different religions and parables from different religions, because I think there is so much goodness and so much that is beautiful to be learned from them. I really like this book. I like how Usborne manages to pack in a lot of information with beautiful graphics, and they are very respectful of all the different faiths in this book, and I very much look forward to using it. This book we haven't used yet. We have looked through it for pictures, especially when one of their friends is celebrating a festival in their religion, and we can look it up and see exactly what it's about. So I really like that about this. Usborne Time Traveler is one of my son's most favorite books. I received this from Bookshark last year, and I'm so happy that I was exposed to it because they have the cutest idea. The student is meant to put on a helmet, and if you follow me on Instagram, my son actually went and got, like, I think a Star Wars helmet and put it on and made it his Time Traveler helmet. And then in each time period, you meet an actual fictional family and you go through it. So here you have Viking Raiders, and it'll say, your magic time travel helmet has brought you to Nutt's Farm, which stands on the shores of southern Norway. Winter is over and everyone is busy working on the land. There's a lot to be done. And it talks about where he lives and how his village is organized. And then it'll talk about what's inside the house with these beautiful graphics and key features about whatever civilization you're in right then. So the pictures are really detailed and easy to understand, and it's easy to do a deep dive or to do a surface dive depending on the age of your children. And if you see on the bottom here, they have even more detailed information at the bottom, but he really enjoys this book. The Usborne Book of the Ancient World is one of the books that we're planning on using this year. And you'll see it's just packed with information. So whatever you wanted to know is pretty much in these books, and you don't have to run around and get a million different types of reference books. It can be a little bit overwhelming to expect kids to read through this at least my early elementary age. So we use these books more for the pictures right now, and I'll read through ahead of time and kind of highlight out some interesting features that I think they might be interested in, or I'll let my son flip through a section and he can tell me what he finds interesting. Sometimes, especially with pictures like this, we'll look through them together and just learn together, because there's so many things you find out in these books that you probably don't remember from school or that you never learned. The Usborne Encyclopedia of World History is also internet linked, and this is one of our spines for this year through Build Your Library. And as you can see, it's also gorgeously illustrated with both illustrations and photographs. So here you can see like an actual photograph of lava pouring out of a volcano and the Parthenon here, but then you also have illustrations interspersed throughout. So really the quality of these books is amazing. And just to point out, when they say internet linked, it's linked all throughout. It's not just that there's an internet link at the beginning of the book or the end. Here you have, just for Medieval World, a whole section of quick links. This is another sticker math book that we're actually enjoying this year, and it's just a little bit of two-digit adding. And you know, it just makes math a little bit more entertaining. So if you have a child who's a little bit reluctant one day, it's an easy way of making them more engaged in what they're doing. So here he had to add the lily pads and find these stickers and put in the sums, and he did it all in his head because he enjoyed it. And it's a good way of teaching your kids that they can do these things, and it makes it really fun and enjoyable. And especially when you have children of different ages, so my four-year-old has a lot of interactive activities with stickers and more manipulatives and fun, quote-unquote fun activities at the table. So I like to offer my son things like this as well, like the sticker art book and the sticker math book, so that he can also engage in these fun, lighter activities while doing core curricula. The Usborne Book of Everyday Words is a really fun book, especially if you're teaching sight words or you have an early reader. The pictures are just fun to look through, one, but it also teaches you like some core words. So even if you have like a two-year-old, you can say like, can you find the carpet? Like, can you find this carpet? You can use it as a look and find kind type of book. You can also just use it to say like, what is this? And ask them what the words are. Another way of using it is to teach kids how to spell some simple words like crayon, that it has a Y in it, that a bathtub is a compound word, things like that. So it makes it a fun way to discuss words and vocab at an early age. If you're looking for a general encyclopedia sort of contained in one volume, the Usborne Internet Linked Book of Knowledge is a must because it goes through a variety of different topic areas with this gorgeous flyleaf. And it ranges from everything from astronomy and space, planet Earth, plants and animals, the human body, science and technology, maps, countries and flags, world history, dates and facts and lists. So if you just flip through, here's the circulatory system. You have really gorgeous pictures. The digestive system. And if I've learned anything in a couple years of homeschooling, or 1 year and a month or so, it's that you don't need 1,000 books. You need really good core reference books. And Usborne definitely meets that need because not only do they have good illustrations and photographs, you also have quality information. I've noticed that a lot of reference books for kids will have either or. They'll either have really good information and not enough pictures and photos to engage the children, or they'll have wonderful illustrations and no substance. So I really like how Usborne meets the need for both. They have quality information. The books can last you a long time. When you're dealing with a small child, you can talk about the eye, you can talk about the pupil, the eyelashes, the iris, the eyelid, for example, and you might not get into the inner structure of the eye. But then next year or the following year, you can use this picture and talk more about that. The following year after that, you can talk about focus and how that works. So you can build on these books year by year, and they should last all the way through high school because things get very, very complicated, like genes and DNA, right? They're bending light. They are really beautiful books and easy to adapt to different age levels. So here you can see really high quality maps and a timeline of important history dates. So returning to your younger children, the Usborne Picture Dictionary is a fun book when you open it up. It is literally what it says it is. It's a picture dictionary. So it's the perfect type of dictionary for a first grader, a second grader, early elementary, probably even to late elementary. Really nice. It shows them how a dictionary works without overwhelming them. So it's a really good book to teach how to use a dictionary and to look up definitions and what things mean in a dictionary, like the first definition, the second definition, an example sentence, how you would do that. And then it also has the alphabet at the bottom of every page to show you exactly where that letter falls in the alphabet, which I think is always a nice feature. Usborne also makes readers sort of in the vein of Bob books, but a little bit more complex and well illustrated. So this is part of the Usborne very first reading set. And I think I have a bunch, like 15 maybe? I'm not sure exactly how many are in the set, but I only brought one to show you. As you can see, it has very simple reading down here, but you can make the story more interesting by reading more complicated words over here. And I think that's much more engaging for my daughter than, for example, the Bob books. So you can read here, "Well done, Pirate Pat," and the child gets to read again and again, "Pat, Pat, Pat." So they are contributing to the story as they read, and it's a fun story. Last but certainly not least are these thick little tomes of stories, and I have six of these. I have the Norse fairy tales, or the Norse myths. I have the Greek myths, and these illustrated fairy tales. I have the illustrated stories from Shakespeare, and I have a few others that I can't remember off the top of my head, but I saw these at a convention last year, and I could not resist them, and they are just beautiful. And you can see everything from the flyleaf to the illustrations is lovely. The stories are very manageable and perfect for reading to your children in the evenings. It comes with a little satin ribbon for a bookmark. So these are definitely keepsake books, and I just adore them. They're hardbound, and they have a little cushion to the cover, so it makes it even more luxurious. This is the illustrated stories from Shakespeare. And I haven't started reading these, but my idea is to start off with the illustrated stories here just as nighttime reading so they grow familiar with the stories, and then start into a little bit more complex study of Shakespeare maybe next year. So I'm really looking forward to it. And it has, let's see, it has Twelfth Night, Romeo and Juliet, The Tempest, Midsummer Night's Dream, Macbeth, Hamlet, and then a little section on the life of Shakespeare himself, which is interesting. So you guys, these are some of my books from Usborne that we have loved. I actually wanted to show you our amazing flat books from Usborne, but I have packed them away because, as you know, we're staging our house, and definitely make sure to check those out on Claire's site tomorrow. I really hope you will tune in again for tomorrow's video and see what Claire has to offer. I know that I would have loved having somebody make a list for me of books that would suit perhaps some of the unit studies I'm planning, or my curricula for that year, or the ages of my children. It's definitely worth looking into. I see us having a lot of these books for several years. They are worth the investment, and you don't often find them in thrift stores or anything because people have kept them. I mean, I can't imagine me getting rid of this book for a very, very long time, until my kids are out of high school, certainly. So thank you so much for watching, you guys. I hope you enjoyed this little foray into Usborne, and I hope you tune in tomorrow. I so appreciate you, and I wish you the very best day.